Imagine, if you will, the mid-60s. It's a time of cultural revolution, a time when music is not just an art form, but a statement. It's a time when a new wave of artists is breaking boundaries and pushing the envelope. Enter Frank Zappa, a man whose music was as unique and unorthodox as the man himself. His debut album, Freak Out, released in 1966, was a bold, audacious statement. It was an album that refused to conform to the conventions of the time. The first track, Hungry Freak's Daddy, bursts forth with a raw, unfiltered energy. It's a biting satire of American consumerism, wrapped in a blistering rock and roll package. The song's unconventional structure and Zappa's distinctive vocal delivery set the tone for the entire album. Next up is I Ain't Got No Heart, a song that defies conventions in every possible way. It's a sonic collage of different genres, blending rock, doo-wop, and avant-garde music into a seamless whole. The lyrics, filled with Zappa's signature wit and sarcasm, are a direct assault on the superficiality of popular culture. The third track, Who Are the Brain Police, is a surreal, nightmarish soundscape. It's a song that challenges the listener, forcing them to question the nature of reality and the structures of power. The unsettling use of sound effects and the eerie, dissonant harmonies make this track an unforgettable experience. Go Cry on Somebody Else's Shoulder takes us on a completely different journey. It's a doo-wop parody that showcases Zappa's knack for genre bending and his talent for pastiche. The song's humorous lyrics and playful melodies provide a welcome respite from the album's heavier themes. Motherly Love is a tongue-in-cheek take on the rock and roll love song. It's filled with double entendres and cheeky innuendos, all delivered with Zappa's characteristic dry wit. The song's catchy, upbeat melody is a perfect counterpoint to its subversive lyrics. The final track, The Return of the Son of Monster Magnet, is a 14-minute sonic experiment. It's a testament to Zappa's fearless creativity, a sound collage that pushes the boundaries of what music can be. It's chaotic, it's unpredictable, and it's utterly captivating. Freak Out was more than just an album. It was a statement, a manifesto. It challenged the status quo and pushed the boundaries of what was considered acceptable in popular music. It was an album that refused to fit into a neat little box, much like Zappa himself. Today, Freak Out stands as a testament to Zappa's unmatched creativity and his relentless pursuit of artistic freedom. It's an album that continues to inspire and challenge, an album that refuses to be forgotten. And that, my friends, is the legacy of Freak Out.